Hello everyone, welcome to Planet Ayurveda YouTube channel. Today we are going to discuss about a very common condition, and people come to their physicians and complain about this condition very often. It is called as jaundice, and for more details here is Dr. Vikram Chauhan, who will tell us about jaundice in total detail, each and everything. Sir, please.
Yes, I would like to discuss about this topic because it's a very common topic. Many patients come with this condition. Jaundice is when there is a pigmentation of the body, yellow discoloration. The patient's skin becomes yellow, the eyes become yellow, and the whole body becomes yellowish. So that is called jaundice. Why this happened? Because there is a pigment in our blood that is secreted by liver, that is called bilirubin. When the bilirubin level goes beyond certain point, up to from 1.1 to certain limits, above that limit, then the skin becomes yellowish. So that is called jaundice. And why this happens? Why this bilirubin goes up? Because there can be obstruction in the flow of the bilirubin. The bilirubin is not flowing through the bile or through the intestines. It is stuck somewhere. So it is called obstructive jaundice. Whenever there is obstruction in the flow of the bilirubin. Whenever there is a hemolysis, because if the blood is broken down, the RBCs are broken down, especially in malaria, that also leads to production of this bilirubin pigment, that is hemolytic. And another one is infective jaundice. Whenever there is some infection or inflammation, infection can be of various viruses or bacteria or any other infection, especially hepatitis B virus or C viruses, hepatitis viruses. So that leads to jaundice.
Sir, is there any specific causes which can be explained regarding jaundice in Ayurveda?
According to Ayurveda, these are the similar causes are there. Whenever there is there are different terminology. It is a complication of Pandu. The disease is called Pandu anemia. So in anemia also there is a lack of RBCs, less hemoglobin is there. That Pandu, the complication of Pandu are called, it's called Kamla and Halimak, and different type of complicated Kamlas are there. So Kamla is a terminology given in Ayurveda for jaundice.
Okay, sir, obviously our viewers will want to know that what Ayurvedic herbs or what Ayurvedic medications, formulations will be very much effective in treating jaundice.
Yes, Ayurveda has given a lot of information on this Kamla disease or the jaundice, depending on various causes. For example, if the cause is because of hepatitis B virus or any other hepatitis virus, we have herbs like Kutki, Bringraj, Makoe, Kalmegh, Bhumi Amla. They are very useful. They are called Pitta Virechak Aushdiya. Pitta Virechak means when we release the Pitta, when we squeeze the gallbladder, when we support the liver to work at optimum level. Whenever there is there are toxins coming in the liver. Liver is like an immigration officer, and whatever we eat, it goes in our liver. If we eat some bad food, it goes to the liver, and there is a burden on the liver. So liver processes the toxins at one side and real food at one side. If in case the liver is damaged, that is called hepatitis. So hepatitis A is because of the food. Hepatitis B, C, D and E, B, C, E are because of the viruses. So if the liver is damaged because of infection, it is called infective jaundice, and that infection has to be cleared. We have certain herbs like Phalanthus Niruri or Bhumi Amla. Bhumi Amla is so effective in killing the virus. This slowly the hepatitis B or C viruses, they come down, their level becomes neutralized. So we use anti-infective herbs, and we also use herbs which are supporting to the liver function. So this is how we are treating jaundice patients, and underlying cause is focused at, and we treat the underlying condition. That's how the Ayurvedic medicines, they are working.
And anything specific about diet or lifestyle people have to change?
Of course.
They are being affected with jaundice.
Of course, people, they are damaging their livers using many chemicals. Many allopathic medicines are given in without any prescriptions. They are doing self-medication of painkillers. They are causing liver damage. Fried food, packaged food, all this alcohol. Sometimes people suffer from jaundice or cirrhosis because of the alcohol use. So alcohol is very intoxicating to the liver. So all these things should be avoided. Anything which is growing in the forest is coming from the fields, which is growing on the trees, that should be eaten, not anything else which is coming from the factory. Biscuits and this pastas and this whatever food you,
all the fast food,
fast food. That is very dangerous for the liver. Fried food is very dangerous. So drink a lot of water, optimum quantity of water. If you have ascites, if the liver is damaged and if there is cirrhosis, then the water intake should be limited to 1 liter maximum, and also the salt intake should be limited. But if there is simple jaundice, then you can have water. And fruits are okay, all apples and papayas and pears, all fruits are okay. Sour fruits should be consumed in very less, little quantity, because sour can sometimes increase the pitta. So that's why we usually say no sour food, sour fruits. Melons are okay. All such fruits are okay.
Okay, thank you very much, sir, for this anonymous knowledge regarding jaundice.
Thank you.
That's all for today. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thanks a lot.